Okay, so it's 2:16, and I think we're supposed to start boarding at 2:22. They both the announcement.
Passengers who are rechecked in from terminal and flight 437 to Piabo International. You can ask the panel on immigration and security and assemble in the departure area to wait your following instructions. Once again, passengers who are rechecked in from terminal and flight 437 to Piabo International. You can ask the panel on immigration and security and assemble in the departure area to wait your following instructions. Thank you.
I don't know what they just said. That's probably me. Let me go find out. Put it by the check to see if it could go into the thing, and I'm like over there, I'm like, all right, so what, we're trying to prove that this is too big to go in there. Okay. So I put it there, and of course it cannot fit because I know it's too big to go in there. They're very strict here in St. Vincent when it comes to the airline, and so of course I put it, the young man goes, oh, it's too big. I'm like, in my head like, duh, yeah, we all know that, don't need to play games. But I didn't say that out loud, of course. And then I just, you know, like, they're tagging it. So I said, okay. And I put my lock on it. And that's it. I didn't have to worry about my carry-on with me. So I will pick it up in Miami. And we'll see if that happens tomorrow morning when I head out of Miami. All right, let me show you outside. All right, so this is the airport outside. I already said the prayer.
guy, please remain seated with your seatbelts fastened until we arrive at the gate. If the captain turns off the seatbelt sign, this will be your only indication that it's safe to move about the cabin. Be careful open overhead bins as we have shifted during landing, and keep the aisles clear of all carrying items. We are to remind all customers that this will be your first point of entry in the United States. You will have to clear immigration and customs. If you have any questions regarding your connecting flight or your luggage, please see the ground personnel. On behalf of all American employees and your Miami-based flight crew, we'd like to thank you for flying with us, and we hope to see you again. Have a great evening.
This is the second or third movement. There's a connected flight. We're now following this guy in the blue. What's inside? And it said, oh, the connecting flight is another line. Sent us through a gate. And through that gate, we ended up back out here. And now we got switched off and we're coming someplace else. So we'll see. Priority. We'll see what happens. My flight is not until tomorrow, but other people have flights in 40 minutes. All right, so this is me on the return trip. Another sleepover, layover. Another layover. I have, what time is it now? 5 minutes to one. My flight out of here is at 8. I don't even remember. I found a section and it turned out that it's where I'm supposed to be flying out of if they don't change it in the morning. D9. It's not cold. It is not cold over here in D9, thank God. So I am about to take a little nap. And so I cleaned off the seat that I'm on. No one behind me. My bag. Where my bag at? Oh, ingenious me, you know what I did? So of course my carry-on is really too big to be a carry-on. So they took it. And before they were taking it, when I was leaving St. Vincent, genius me said, oh, let me put on my little TSA lock, you know? Go ahead. But apparently I didn't walk with that key. I left that key at home. So I could not get in my bag. But thank God, my toothpaste and my stuff that I need in the morning is in my other bag. And I'm sitting here myself like, bro, you are crazy. Because I can remember now, you know, like, had both keys and I chose the wrong one. It wasn't even a key that looked like it. The other key was small, yes, but it was to a different thing, and brought the wrong key. Good thing I don't need anything in that bag, and hopefully they won't need to go in that bag because then they're gonna break my lock. But nowadays people could go into whatever they want to go into anyway. Anyway, all of that chit chat, almost home. It's been a good three week vacation. Going back to busyness and other busyness. Because I had time to do a lot of thinking and planning and so forth. So we'll see what the remainder of 2023 brings later. Oh, you know what else I noticed? The airport is more active this time around than last time, because I've been seeing a stream of people coming on flights. So there's that. All right, folks, later. Wow. Okay.
we need to try to start to find that side.
Yeah?
We're going to try to now start to find that side, come on. Garden, man.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord.
Yeah, man, they got
this up on wow. Bicycle, man. Then throw a man,
find the road up there, man.
Wow. Wow. Road is being fixed.
No, he said, don't talk too hard. We end up remaining like this.
No, Bobby, it's gonna be fixed. It's gonna be fixed.
Well,
we gotta claim
so.
It. We gotta claim it.
Yeah, I hope so. Well, I know these people.
Yeah, yeah, I know. Trust me, I've heard.
Yeah, man, then
I've heard. Look. Wow.
This country of the people in it.
The first time I came down here was what, like 8 years ago? 7, 8 years ago? The first time I see an actual road. Third time they don't say you're too late to come. Okay. All right then. Later. We even have mud. Oh, what? They gonna fix over here too? Oh, that's for the drainage or something. Okay. What they start. Mommy, the road. Oh my goodness, this is amazing. I have to call my mother as soon as I reach inside. That's always my mother complain. The road's so bad. Oh, this is for somebody else.